Hi, welcome. Thanks for joining me. On this episode of Build Your Own, we're going to build, price, and option a 2019 Audi RS3. Before we do, however, I just want to remind you that if you find this build and price review helpful, informative, or entertaining, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Take one look at the RS3 from its large front air intakes to the massive tailpipes, and you know it's ready to rock. With a 394 horsepower turbocharged 2.5-liter five-cylinder engine under the hood, the 2019 Audi RS3 has the muscle to back up its menacing appearance. A 7-speed dual-clutch automatic routes torque to all four wheels. In testing, the RS3 hit 0 to 60 miles an hour in a scant 3.9 seconds, and it boasts a redline of 6,900 RPMs. The RS3 is what happens when you fortify Audi's class-leading A3 entry-level sedan with a 394 horsepower turbocharged 5-cylinder engine. Naturally, the brakes and suspension have been upgraded to match, and most of the A3s and S3s optional equipment has been made standard on the RS3. So it says power cords. Let's just jump right into this. I'm really digging the Audi products. I just got done doing the brand new Audi e-tron SUV. They're talking about right here, Audi Sport. You see that? They're saying the latest 5-cylinder power plant carries on tradition of Audi Sport. Well, you know what? I just did a whole review of Audi Sport, its racing history, and Audi Sport DNA. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a link up, because this will make it easy. I'm going to put a link up to the Audi playlist. Inside that playlist, you're going to find all the Audis I've done. I've done an A3, S4s, RS7s, you name it, the new e-tron SUV, it's all in there. So I'm going to put a link up to that playlist. All the Audi stuff you want to check out is over there. So I already kind of talked a lot about the engine in the beginning, but you know what? It doesn't hurt to just go over this information as they wrote it down. So the RS3, it's got that 2.5-liter engine. It makes 394 horsepower. It makes 354 pound-feet of torque, and it's got even a more distinct engine note, right? That's available with the sport exhaust system within the available dynamic package. We'll have to take a close look at that for sure. RS marks the style. It says the look and feel of race-inspired performance is showcased throughout the Audi RS3. Look how hot it looks. I just saw this car at the Portland Auto Show. From the standard S Sport seats and fine Nappa leather to the widened front fenders and RS-designed oval exhaust outlets, the dynamic lines put your adrenaline in motion. The car will certainly do that. It certainly seems like it would, doesn't it? It's a nice, nice, sporty car, and I'm sure it lays down its power real nice. It's got magnetic ride control, it says here. Let's move this down so we can see a little bit better. It says the Audi Magnetic Ride helps to maximize handling dynamics. Audi Magnetic Ride uses a synthetic blend of oils that contain tiny magnetic particles, adjusting the firmness of the dampers within a few milliseconds by creating a magnetic field within the shock absorber. Then, of course, they're going to talk about the legendary Audi Quattro all-wheel drive. And since this is a RS car that has the Audi Sport DNA, then the Quattro system is adjusted accordingly because of that. And the Quattro system is actually rear biased. Yeah, it is four-wheel drive, but it leans a little bit more towards putting power to the rear wheels. Okay, so it says the RS3 sedan employs permanent quattro all-wheel drive with no set torque distribution. The all-wheel drive system adjusts and fine-tunes to help maximize grip and overall control, sending power to the wheels with the most traction. So I know you can see the instrument display down here. Let me give you a better shot. You see that whole instrument cluster? You see how there's not one analog gauge on there. There's not one speedometer needle or tachometer needle. This is a whole TFT screen, and this is hot. Audi calls this the Audi Virtual Cockpit. The available Audi Virtual Cockpit is a fully digital 12.3-inch instrument display that allows the driver to customize information, such as MMI navigation. That's the whole Audi, that's what they call their infotainment, is MMI. Audio, offering classic and infotainment modes, as well as Google Earth. The RS3 sedan has a third option, sport mode, with a large central tachometer, right, like we can see here. This is obviously the sport mode that displays that large central tachometer and performance statistics, such as a lap timer, horsepower, and torque gauge, and G-meter. Can we see any of that stuff? No, it's in German here, so I don't know what that word means right here, but there's something for a percentage that might be boost. I see the word boost down here. So that's real cool. So you can get the whole sport layout when you want to get, you know, have fun with it. Okay, now they want to tell us about the MMI. That's, you know, it kind of looks like the BMW iDrive or the BMW Command, and everybody's kind of following suit with this kind of thing. But here's what they say about there. They say the available MMI touch with handwriting recognition, the only other company I know that did that was BMW on their iDrive, allows the driver to write their entry rather than selecting letters or numbers and more easily navigate maps by moving a finger across the touchpad. It's worth noting that we are going on over the overview page. You can see that this link up here is in red, and they're kind of giving us a highlight of technology, design, performance. And then we're going to actually take a deeper look at technology, design, and performance. So this is kind of just giving us a quick little overview of all of that. Here they are talking about that motorsport DNA. So that's what I'm saying. They are real serious about their motorsports DNA and how it transfers to the RS line of cars, right? So it says motorsport DNA fuels the alluring look of the 2019 RS3 sedan, from the aggressive RS specific, let me move this, exterior, to the standard S Sport seats trimmed in fine Napa leather. The feel of the track isn't far away. Let's click on these and get some closer looks of this gallery. All right, here we go. 19-inch five-arm blade design wheels and matte type, or sorry, 19-inch five-arm blade design matte titanium wheels. Honeycomb single-frame grille. Looking hot. I love how the quattro is written down here. It's real nice. Small car, but awesome. Full LED headlights. And they're showing the 2018 models, they keep telling us down here as well, right? 2018 models shown. Standard LED taillights. Here you can get a good shot of the exhaust, right? You can see that whole exhaust looking all menacing and chunky and nice oval dual exhaust tips. It says body-colored rear lip spoiler and signature RS design oval exhaust notes. Outlets, I'm sorry. Striking exterior design, and it looks like we're about to get into the interior next. Let's check it out. Look at that. Dual zone automatic climate control. Look at the Alcantara on the steering wheel. FYI, here's a USB port I see. What do we got next? Three-spoke, flat-bottom, multifunction steering wheel with available Audi virtual cockpit. Remember, that's that whole instrument cluster right here. Look at the nice dead pedal. The Audis are just a great execution of everything they do, it seems like, and the fit and finish to boot. There's the Audi RS carbon inlays. Look at these seats, buddy. Look at these seats. S Sports seats trimmed in fine Napa leather, contrast diamond stitching, and RS embossing. You know, I'm all about certain cars I like, and boy, geez, whew. This Audi RS S3, this thing, RS3, is really hot. It's a tiny car, but it is just fine, isn't it? Now, what do they say here? 7-speed S-tronic dual-clutch automatic transmission. Right, kind of redundant. We got it. But I see a little Alcantara around the shifter ball, too. So that's pretty cool. Let's move on. So we're not quite ready to build our RS3 yet, but the reason why we're making a pit stop here is because they have colors. They have colors, exterior colors, for the 2019 Audi RS3, right, with all that Audi Sport DNA in it. Looking quite sporty. Here it is in Nardo Gray. And then we have Glacier White. I usually like white cars. I like it. Then we have it in Tango Red. And I like how, you know, just like the S line of cars, it gets a little silver mirror caps and everything. Then we have Daytona Gray. It looks good in every color, to be honest with you. Mythos Black. And finally, last but not least, we have Aura Blue. Now, there's been many cars, and I've done hundreds of cars. There's been times I've done cars and I say, I don't like any of the colors. I don't like any of these colors. I like all the colors on this 2019 Audi RS3. They all look good, but which one will I choose? We won't know until we get there, because we are going to do the build and price. We're going to go through everything else first. Here's the model lineup. There's only one. There's only one RS3. There aren't different trim levels, okay? It tells you what the available engine is, and it gets the Audi magnetic ride, and it's got a specific RS tune on it. RS mode specific front fascia. See what I tell you? They're serious about this RS stuff. They're serious about the RS stuff. Here's some quick specs, right? We know it's a 2.5-liter engine. It makes 394 horsepower at 5,850 RPMs all the way up to 7,000 RPMs. Does 0 to 60 in 3.9 seconds. And it's got a torque. Its torque, the engine torque, is 354 pound-feet of torque, which is a lot in this little bitty car. And what's even more impressive is its torque, that it makes it from 1,700 RPMs, which is basically just off idle, all the way up to almost 6,000 RPM, stopping at 5,850 RPM. We know that it's got that 7-speed S-tronic dual-clutch automatic transmission and quattro all-wheel drive, does 155 miles an hour, and it's got a 20-valve engine, dual overhead, with Audi valve lift. And they say that the combined fuel economy is to be determined, basically. They're not going to tell us. All right, so that was the overview page. Remember, if we look up here at again now, we're done with the overview page. We're over here on technology. So we're going to go through this page, and we can see that the slider is pretty thick. So there's not a whole bunch of information on this page. We're going to go through this technology page, go through the design page, performance, take a look at this trim and specs again one more time to see if there's any additional information. Surely there will be. And then we'll do our build and price of our Audi RS3. Now, if I can save the configuration, meaning download and save it to, you know, the PDF, then I'll put a link in the description below, and that'll be available in the description right now, okay? So let's find out about this Audi virtual cockpit. Some of this is going to be redundant, but it's okay. The available Audi virtual cockpit can make for a highly elevated driving experience. Set in a fully digital 12.3-inch instrument display and Audi virtual cockpit, the Audi virtual cockpit allows you to customize information, right? We know that. So I'll kind of stop there. We'll take another look at it because it's pretty, and now we'll move on. Now they're going to tell us that they have the Audi smartphone interface. So this standard feature enables Apple CarPlay and Google Android Auto integration, allowing access to your compatible smartphone's features such as navigation, phone, music, and select third-party apps, and can be controlled through the MMI interface, voice control system, or the steering wheel controls. All right, now let's find out about this MMI, see what they're talking about. MMI Touch. MMI Touch with handwriting recognition technology allows the driver to write their entry rather than selecting letters or numbers and more easily navigate maps by moving a finger across the touchpad. See, Audi Connect. You can connect your Audi RS3 to the world with Audi Connect, an intuitive system that integrates sought-after information like Google Earth, weather conditions, and traffic information. The Audi RS3 comes standard with a 6-month trial subscription and Audi Connect, a Wi-Fi hotspot, and more. Combined with in-vehicle 4G LTE connectivity, getting connected has never been easier. So that's the Audi Connect. Here's a great shot of that Audi virtual cockpit, and I just can't get enough of it. I mean, I'd want to buy the car just because of this by itself. And then the Bang & Olufsen system, because I love the Bang & Oli, as I like to call it. The available Bang & Olufsen sound system and the Audi RS3 is a natural blend of state-of-the-art automotive technology with superior audio innovation. With 14 fully active loudspeakers and 705 watts of power, right? This system bumps is what they should say, that it just throws down, right? Basically, this little car is going to throw down on the sounds, and I got just the music for it. I have to take a minute to note what a wonderful execution of information is on this Audi website. You see how they stack this information, and then you have all these clickable links without making the page super, super long, but it still gives you all the information, but in little bite-sized nuggets? I love that. I bet you love that too. Let's find out about the driver assistance. It says, let innovation be your guide. On the road, shift happens. Constantly moving vehicles, traffic, and obstacles. The Audi suite of available driver assistance technologies can help alert you to some of the unpredictable shifts that come your way. One of those is Audi PreSense Basic. In the case of an impending collision, standard Audi PreSense Basic can assist to prepare the vehicle for impact. This process includes beginning to close the side windows and panoramic sunroof and pre-tensioning the front safety belts. Then we have Rear Cross Traffic Assist. This available feature uses sensors to help scan the area behind the vehicle and sides, while a standard rear view camera helps provide additional visibility when backing up, as in reversing out of perpendicular parking spaces. Yeah, you get it. You're at the grocery store or wherever. You're backing up and you can't see. People are flying back and forth down the aisle. A lot of these new cars now have this rear cross traffic alert. They all call them a little bit different names because they all got to be unique, but it all basically does the same thing with varying degrees of what they can do. This is a cool feature not to take away from what Audi's doing. It's awesome. Then there's this Parking System Plus. This standard feature uses front and rear acoustic sensors to help detect when you are close to another object. Okay. While a standard rear view camera helps provide additional visibility when backing up. Then lastly, you have this Audi Adaptive Cruise Control with Stop and Go. Now, the 2019 Audi RS3 offers available Audi Adaptive Cruise Control with Stop and Go, which utilizes braking and acceleration to help maintain a set distance from the vehicle in front. The stop and go function allows for automatic braking to a full stop and will resume with the flow of traffic at the driver's command. All right, well, now we're going to move on. Now, we went through the technology. We learned a lot of good information. Now we're on to design. Here's what we're going to do. I can tell you right now that we're going to skip over that gallery because it's going to be the same photos, so we're not going to check that out. But we are going to read about the rest of the information that they have on the page. So, it says the aggressive exterior of this 2019 Audi RS3 makes its presence felt. A signature, hang on a second, let me scroll that down, just a skosh so we can see the pictures. A signature RS single frame grille, that's right here, right? With the RS design exhaust outlet, we saw that in the other picture, and rear lip spoiler, which we can kind of catch a look right here, embody its motorsport tuned performance, right? They keep always playing back to that Audi Sport DNA stuff, don't they? Oh, check it out. Here's a package that you can get. The Black Optic Package. Be bold, the available, and they got it in white, my favorite color too for cars, honestly. Be bold, the available Black Optic Package features a black optic exterior trim with quattro script on the front. 19-inch 5-arm blade design wheels in black finish, a black rear lip spoiler, and exterior mirror housings in high-gloss black. I like. So, real quick, they're just going to tell us. We're not going to look at the photos because we did. It says, the interior, the refined side of track-inspired design. The Audi RS3 brings a feeling of motorsport heritage to the cockpit, fusing performance and elegance to create a driver-oriented environment. The rush of the track meets the comfort of the road. It gives you the best of both worlds, doesn't it? Really nice car. I did actually sit in this car at the Portland Auto Show, and it's nice. Oh, what's this package? Ah, the RS Design Package. Is this what gives you the Alcantara? Check it out. Available on the 2019 RS3, the RS Design Package embodies high performance with the RS embroidered floor mats. That's going to be down here. Alcantara knee pads. I think that's right here. See how there's Alcantara on the side? And then with crescendo red stitching and more, blah, 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 blah. That's pretty cool. So we got that optic package, there's the RS design package, so we can really make this thing super expensive. That's what it comes down to, but who cares about the price? You're going to get what you want, man. It's about getting what you want. All right, let's talk performance here. This is what it's all about. This is the heart of any RS car. What lies beneath? The RS3 features the powerhouse 2.5-liter 5-cylinder TFSI engine paired to a 7-speed S-tronic dual clutch transmission by producing 394 horsepower and 354 pound-feet of torque, which is available at engine speeds as low as 1700 rpm, which is just basically off idle. The RS3 can sprint from 0 to 60 miles an hour in 3.9 seconds, a powerful force to be reckoned with. You can be sure they are not lying there. They are not lying. This car will easily embarrass some much more expensive, bigger hardware out there, whether from Audi or otherwise. Here's a nice shot of that rear spoiler and the dual oval exhaust tips. This car is looking hunkered. Look how the wheels are just over that wheel well. This thing's sitting down about as low as it can go. The quattro all-wheel drive. The RS3 employs permanent quattro all-wheel drive with no set torque distribution. They already just said that, didn't they? The all-wheel drive system adjusts and fine-tunes to help maximize grip and overall control, sending power to the wheels with the most traction. What's this? Tuned for the track and road. An available fixed suspension on the 2019 RS3 replaces Audi Magnetic Ride with a precision-tuned sport feel that's at home on the road, the track, and everything else. So you do not have to use the magnetic shocks. You can go old school with a fixed suspension. I might be interested in that, actually. We'll see how that works. See, the speed of sound. The 2.5-liter turbocharged engine made it to a 7-speed S-tronic dual-clutch automatic transmission is known for its unique firing order and inimitable sound. The 1-2-4-5-3 ignition sequence produces a special rhythmic and distinct engine note that can be controlled by opening the flaps of the standard RS exhaust system. All right, so we went through performance, and I said that we'd get over here to the trim and specs, and we did, and we are, I should say. And the trim and specs, we already saw that part. They had that on the overview page. We already saw this specs overview. They already had that on the overview page. But what they didn't have is they didn't have this, and we can see that it's got a toggle, exterior and interior, engine and drivetrain, body steering, and EPA estimate. So let's break this down and take a look at this stuff a little close, and then we'll get into our build-in price. Okay, so the height of this vehicle, this is all in inches, mind you, 55 inches. The length, 176.3. Wheelbase, 103.6 inches. With the mirrors, the width is 77.2 inches. Front headroom is 36.5 inches. Rear headroom is 36.1 inches. Front leg room, 41.2 inches. Rear leg room, 35.1 inches. Okay, here's some engine drivetrain and suspension specs, right? We got our engine displacement, horsepower, torque, acceleration, transmission. We already know that stuff, so I'm not going to go over it. Front suspension, we kind of know this too, but it's a McPherson strut front suspension with that magnetic ride, right? And then that rear suspension tells you it's a four-link rear suspension with Audi magnetic ride with an optional fixed sport suspension system that we can get. And I think I like that optional fixed suspension system. It kind of sounds interesting to me. Here under body steering and brakes specs, lightweight construction. They're talking about the body, fully galvanized steel unibody with aluminum hood and sub and front subframe. It's got a turning diameter of 36.1 feet, this vehicle. Its front brakes are 14.6 inch ventilated 8-piston front brakes. They're going to be expensive to service. And then rear brakes, 12.2 inch ventilated discs. All right, well, we've seen what we need to see, didn't we? What does this do when you hit the plus? Okay, we've seen what we need to see. And so now, yep, you guessed it. I'm over here at the build and price. We're going to do a build and price and jump into this. So let me just scroll down. We got to go through some tabs, right? Trims and engine, exterior, interior, packages and options, and finally accessories. So there's only one trim level, right? This car starts with an MSRP starting price of $56,200, right? And it comes with all this stuff. We've already read everything, so we don't need to do any more reading. So let's go ahead and hit this continue button and continue. All right, so what color do you think I'm going to pick? Huh? What color do you think I'm going to pick? Am I going to pick that white? Where is that white? Anyway, there it is. Glacier White Metallic. It's $595. I want to go with the Glacier White Metallic. We're going to go with the Glacier White Metallic. I don't think I've done a white car in a while. We're going to do that. And then we're going to take a look at these wheels. What do we got for wheels? We've got the 19-inch 5-arm blade design. Then you've got the Black Optic package. Well, I know that I want the Black Optic package. So, yeah, it's telling us that there's a conflict because we got to get that package, right? It says we got to get these wheels. It's plus $1,300. And then we got to add the dynamic package. And inside the dynamic package is, I guess, the Black Optic package. So let's add this to the configuration. So now we have the Black Optic package. Did that change the things up here? Yep, it sure did, because now we got the black mirror caps and all that. That looks super sporty. Looks super sporty. All right, so that dynamic package, just so we know, what was all included in that was those 19-inch 5-arm blade design wheels, different set of tires. You got the summer performance tires. You got the red brake calipers and a sport exhaust system with black tips. That's the dynamic package for $1,450, basically $1,500. Then, of course, we got the Black Optic package. We just read about that a few minutes ago. And so we'll continue and go on to interior. All right. So here we are on interior. And what do we want? Do we want those sport seats? Nope. I want these. Oh, they all come S-Sport front seats. Those are standard. I guess do we want it with black with rock gray stitching? Or do we want the crescendo red stitching? Do I want the crescendo red stitching? So if I do that, what do we have to do now? It says necessary customizations. We got to remove that fine Nappa leather. We got to add the RS Design Select interior. And we got to add the Audi Sport carbon inlays. I'm not going to argue about that. Let's add that to the configuration and get on down the road. Although now that I see the red, do I want the red? Do I want to look at that red every day? Do I want to look at that red every day? I think the answer to that is going to be no. I don't think I want to look at that red every day. I don't think I want to look at the red every day. I think I like it in all black straight across. We still have our Audi Sport carbon inlay, so you can still select that the way you want. Okay, so we can see that it still gets the Audi Sport carbon inlay. I want to see what it looks like with the aluminum race illuminated inlays. What does that look like? You could barely even see that move. See, you could barely even see that move versus the carbon. And I think I just want the all carbon. So I think we're going to stick with the all carbon. And yeah, let's go ahead and hit continue. Okay, so we've got that Black Optic package we know. Do I want the RS fixed sport suspension? You know I did, so I'm going to go ahead and add that to the configuration. And then we've got the driver assistance package. And that's basically all the high-end technology, right? All the safety equipment stuff. I want that. I'm not going to get chintzy with this car now, right? It's an expensive little car, but I want all the stuff that I want in it. So what are we going to have to do? We're going to have to add the technology package to that. And so it's basically we're going to bump it up almost another $5,000 to get this package. But this car is going to be really loaded. Now, do you need to put all this stuff on to get the Audi RS3 you want? Probably not. Probably not. But I like all this stuff, and that's why I'm, you know, throwing it on there. So what's the deal? The dynamic package, we have that already. The RS design interior, I didn't really like that because I don't think I want the red on the seats. I just don't think I want the red on the seats. I don't want to look at that all day. The technology package, that's the Audi virtual cockpit and the Bang & Olufsen sound system. I'm all over that for $3,200, right? So what does that mean? So we remove the driver assistance package, da-da-da-da-da. They're going to make the adjustments. So we have, hang on one second. There we go. So we have the technology package. Now we do. Let's move on. Do we want to protect our rear seat occupants with thorax side airbags? Sure, why not? Why not? Audi Care. I don't normally get into the Audi Care stuff and all that. That's, you know, when you go and buy your car, that's the stuff you sit down, you figure out. On this channel, we just do the build and price reviews because we like cars on this channel. We don't do all that other boring stuff, okay? Okay, on to accessories. Let's see. Let me scroll down and look at all the accessories first, because oftentimes I'll scroll and then see something because they'll. All right. So I want the all-weather floor mats that say that have like the Audi insignia on there. Oh, that was just for the front. All right. And then give me the rears, I guess. Wow. Give me the illuminated door sills that say Quattro. That's kind of fun. Audi beam rings. It's like the your floodlights. When you open the car, these rings come out. They had them at the Portland Auto Show. They were showing how the Audis had that. It looks really cool. It's worth the $200. It's nice. You can change which one you want. Do you want it to say Quattro or the rings? I think I want it to say rings. I don't need a bike rack or any of the carriers or anything like that. So let's move on to what? Let's move on to the summary. First things first, yep, show us PDF. So yeah, I can print this off. So note that if you like the way I spec'd out this 2019 Audi RS3, you can download the build summary in the description below. It's available right now. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this video up. Basically, this thing started off at $56,200, and we ended up at $65,000. So we put a lot of $8,500 worth of options on there, but we certainly have the Audi RS3 that we want. And this thing is certainly punching above its weight. I have no doubt this car can punch above its weight quite easily. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this video up. If you've made it to the end, you're awesome. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be putting out a lot more content, and it's going to get good. So thank you. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you over the next video.